So then the next special type, I am again taking one question. You can look at this question. This is minimization. So first, what do we need to do? We need to maximize. So Z will be equal to minus 12 x1, minus 18 x1, x2, minus 15 x3. We have done this thing. Now, subjected to, just look at the subjected to condition. 4x1 plus 8x2 plus 6x3, it is greater than. So what will come here is greater than, so it will be minus s1 plus a1 is equal to 64. The next condition is like 3x1 plus 6x2 plus 12x3 minus s2 plus a2 is equal to 96. So since we are asked to solve it by two phase, so first phase will be like, first phase will be maximize z is equal to 0x1 plus 0x2 plus 0x3 plus 0s1 plus 0s2, right? Minus a1, since it is two phase, we have to take minus m, not minus m, but minus a. Minus a1, minus 1 into a1, minus 1 into a2. So we will write everything here, Cj. Before writing Cj, we will write x1, x2, x3, s1, s2, a1, a2. How many equations are there? I'll just try to use the space in a proper way. x1, x2, s1, x1, x2, x3. Then it is s1, s2, a1 and a2. Okay. Now I need to write all the values of the coefficients. So 4, 8, 6. 4, 8, 6. Minus 1, 0, 1, 0. Next it will be 3, 6, 12, 0, minus 1, 0, 1. So identity matrix, since there are two equations, the identity matrix will be of the order 2 by 2. Cj ka value will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, right? Minus 1, minus 1. RHS will be 0. Then RHS ka another side will be 64 and 96, right? So we have found all the values. Now we can write here. Minus 1, minus 1, Zj minus Cj. This will be 0, this will be 0. This we are not bothered to find. So this will be minus 7, this will be minus 14, this will be minus 18, this will be 1 minus 0 will be 1. Again, this will be 0, 1 minus 1 will be 1, 1 minus 0 will be 1, and 1 minus 0 will be 1. So we have found all the values. This is the most negative. Okay, minus 18, so we will find theta 64 by 16, 64 by 16, 64 by 6, I think it is. So it will be 32 by 3, right? 96 by 12, if I'm not wrong, 96 by 12 is 8, right? So which one is the least value? This one is the least, so A2 will leave the iteration, right? And what will enter is X3 will enter. So A1 will be as it is. X3 will enter, A1 will be minus 1, X3 will be 0, Zj minus Cj. Again, we will do what? We will just use our common sense, 1, 0, 0, X3 will be 0, 1, 0, right? What is the key element? Key element will be 12, right? So 3 by 12 will be 1 by 4, 6 by 12 will be 1 by 2, 12 by 12 will be 1, 0 by 12 will be 0, minus 1 by 12, 0, and 1 by 12, right? And this will be 8, correct? So we have got all the values. Now we need to find this values. So this will be like 48 minus 18. Na? 48 minus 18 is 30. 30 by 12 will be, I think 30 by 12 will be more like 10 by 4. 30 by 12. 30 by 12. 10 by 4, which will be 5 by 2, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, 5 by 2. This value will be 96 minus 36. So it will be 60. 60 by 12 will be 5, if I'm not wrong. This will be minus 12. 0 divided by 12 will be minus 1. Okay, you can just check it. 0, this will be 6 by 12, which will be 1 by 2. You need to find this. 0 minus 6 by 12 will be minus 1 by 2. Now I need to find this value. 64 into 12. Just use your calculator and let me know. 64 into 12 minus 96 into 6 divided by 12. Just let me know this value in the chat. Till then, I'll just solve this. This will be minus 84, right? Minus 84, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, minus 84 plus 54. Minus 84 plus 54 will be minus 30. So this will be minus 5 by 2. Okay. This value will be 12 into 14. Just find this value also for me. Minus 12 into 14. This value. I'll just solve this. This will be like 0. 18 by 12. 18 by 12 will be 3 by 2. Okay. I need to find this value. This will be minus 3 by 2. Now, one second. This will be 12 minus 18 minus 6 by 2 will be minus 1 by 2. Minus 6 by 12. If I'm not wrong, this value will be again 3 by 2 in positive sense. Okay. Just let me check this value. 12, right? 12 by 18, right? And this is 18 by 12 by 18 is 2 by 3, I think. This value will be 2 by 3. Okay. 12 by 18 it is. If it is 12 by 18, it should be 2 by 3. And here it is on the last value, it is 18 by 12, so 3 by 2. Just let me know two values. I need to know the answers. Just help me. 16. Okay, this value is 16. And the next value, this one in this column, this value is 16. So nice. What is this value? Let me know this value. Anyone? 12 into 14. Minus 60 by 12, na? Minus 5 it should be. I think minus 5 it should be. Okay. I've got all the values. Now I need to find the most negative. The most negative is this only. This is the most negative. So what will happen? 16 by 5 will be my first theta. 8 into 2, 16 it will become. Right? 8 divided by 1 by 2 is 8 into 2, which is 16. So which one is the least? This one is the least. Okay, so what will leave? A1 will leave the solution, right? A1 will leave and X2 will enter. So see, some magic is happening. A1 is leaving. So automatically X2 is entering. Just give me a second. What is happening? X2 is entering. X3 is as it is. A1 has left the solution. So this is 0. This is 0. X2 is this one. So this will be 1, 0. X3 is this one. This will be 0, 1. This will be 0, 0. This will be ZJ minus CJ. Right? Now we need to find the key element. What will be my key element? I think this will be my key element. If I'm not wrong. Yeah. This will be my key element. Pivot column and pivot row intersection gives us the key element. So we have to divide it by 5. So this will become 1 by 2. Right? This is already 1. This is 0. This will be minus 1 by 5. This will be 1 by 10. This will again be 1 by 5. This will be minus 1 by 10. And this will be 16 by 5. Any doubt? Please mute yourself. Who is this person? Mute yourself. Mute yourself. Who is this person? Mute yourself. Now we need to find these values. I'll just try to solve first this. I think there is some chat. Altamash. I have muted him. Now we need to find this value. Jaldi se karte hain. 5 by 4 minus 5 by 4. Just look at this magic. 5 by 4 minus 5 by 4, 0. Right? Automatic 0. Now this value. We need to find this value, right? So this is 0, and this is, this will be what? Minus 1 by 2, it will become plus 1 by 2, so this will become 1 by 10, right? Okay, now this value, just look at this value. This will be like minus 5 by 12, if I am not wrong, minus 5 by 12. Minus 5 by 12, minus 1 by 4. If it is not wrong, yeah. Minus 5 by 12, minus 1 by 4. We can simplify it. Minus 5 by 12, minus 1 by 4. Okay. So this will be like multiplied by 3. Okay. So this will become minus 8 by 12. Right. Minus 8 by 12 divided by 5. So what it is like? If it is not wrong, 2, 3, okay, so this will be like minus 2 by 15, I think. This point will be minus 2 divided by 15. Just check it once from your end, okay? Okay. Now, this value will be like, if you want to find this value, 0, 1 by 2, so this will be minus 1 by 10, okay? Now we need to find this value. This will be like, if we need to find this value, 5 by 12. Again, it will be 5 by 12 minus minus plus. It will be plus this time. Okay. So this will be 2 by 15. Just try to see it now. Okay. So I have already found this value. Now to find Zj minus Cj, there are two methods. See, this is 0. This is 0. So automatically 0 into 1 by 2, 0 into 0 will be 0. And this x1 is already 0, then this will become 0 automatically. This is x1 is 0, x2 is 0, x3 is 0, s1 is 0 at the upper side. So automatically this will be 0 minus 0. This will also be 0 minus 0. So simple. Okay, now just look at this value. This will be 0 into 1 by 5, 0 into minus 1 by 10. This is going to become 0. So 0 minus of minus 1, since we know the value of a1 at the top is minus 1. So this will automatically become plus 1. I hope you're getting it. This is bound to become plus 1. So whenever artificial variable leaves the solution, okay, leaves solution, in which kind of case? In two-phase method. In two-phase method, all Zj minus Cj will become 0, and all other values, like all artificial variables value in Zj minus Cj will automatically equal to 1. This is the thing that I wanted to say. Now we need to find this value. How can we find this value? 5 into 8 is 40. 40 minus 8, I think if I'm not wrong, 40 minus 8 will be 40 minus 8. 16 into 1 by 2 is 8. So 40 minus 8 is 32. So this will be 32 by 5. So we have got, just give me a second. Okay. Just give me a second. So this is coming out to be 32 by 5. Okay. Now, since we have got all the value of Zj minus Cj is positive, right? Positive or equal to 0. Okay, I hope you're getting. So what do we need to do now? We need to start with second phase. So what is our second phase? Just remember the second phase. Second phase mein what happens? X2 will come, X3 will come. Now all the variables value will come. What are the variables? If I want to write X1, X2, X3, S1, S2. We won't write A1 and A2. This will get eliminated. Now, what is the actual value? Now, what is the actual value of this in the Z equation? We need to see. What are the actual values of this in the Z equation? We will just see it here. What is the value? Minus 12. Just always remember, this was minimization. Okay. So, we are doing maximization. So, we need to consider this minus 12, minus 18, minus 15. Okay. So what we will do here is, we will write minus 12, minus 18, minus 15. This is going to be 0. We need not worry about this. Now, what is the value of x2? Minus 18. What is the value of x3? Minus 15. Now we will copy this values as it is. As I told you earlier, we need to copy this values as it is. Not this. We will not copy this. We will only copy the main values. So this will be 1 by 2, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay. S1 will be minus 1 by 5, if I am not wrong. Minus 1 by 5, 1 by 10, 1 by 10, minus 2 by 15. So I have entered everything. we will enter RHS also as it is. What I'll do here is, just give me a second. RHS ka, what are the values that I got in RHS? 16 by 5 and 32 by 5, if I'm not wrong. Yeah. So I'll write that value also here. So this is 16 by 5. This is 32 by 5. Now what I need to do? Give me a second. This pen is not helping me out. Now what I'll do here is, I'll find ZJ minus CJ. So what will be my ZJ minus CJ? This will automatically be zero because these are the basis variable. So this will be zero. I need not worry about this thing. Okay. Now I need to find other ZJ minus CJ. How will I find this? This will be minus 9, right? 0 minus 9 plus 12 will be 3, right? We need not divide it by any number because we are doing multiplication kind of a thing. So minus 9 plus 12 will be 3. This will be minus 18 plus 18, 0. You can see minus 15. Minus 15 plus 15 again 0. This is also correct. Next thing will be minus minus plus. So plus 18 by 5. Okay, I'm just simplifying it here. 18 by 5. 18 by 5. And next value is minus 15 by 10. 15 by 10 can be written as 3 by 5. So sorry, 15 by 10, na? So I'll write it as it is. Minus 15 by 10. There is nothing here. We need not worry. This is 0. So we just need to simplify this. So we will multiply it by 2. So this will be 36 minus 15. 36 minus 15 will be how much? 21. So this is coming out to be 21 by 10. Not an issue. If I have not done anything incorrect, I think it is correct. Okay. So this will be minus 18 by 10. I am again writing minus 18 by 10 plus it will be 30 by 15. Okay. So now we need to cross multiply. Just simplify minus 18 by 10 plus 30 by 15 and let me know what will be the value like. Minus 18 by 10 plus 30 by 15. Just let me know in the chat. I think this should also be positive. Put it in the chat for me. 1 by 5. It is positive then? Yeah. So this is also coming out to be positive. So we have got, see, all the values of ZJ minus CJ are in the first iteration itself. All ZJ minus CJ are positive. So if all ZJ minus CJ are positive, we are getting to the solution. Just multiply these values. What is the value? Minus 18 into 16 by 5 and minus 15 into 32 by 5. Multiply these values for me and let me know the value. What is this coming out to be? Just multiply and let me know what is the final value that is coming. I don't have the Kelsey. Minus 18 into 16 by 5, minus 15 into 32 by 5. Can anyone let me know? Minus 768 by 5. Okay. So what we have got here is, see, minus 768, RHS is already 0 at the top. So this is minus 768 by 5. Now, I'll just write something for you. X2 is equal to, since this is positive, so we have got to the solution. X2 is coming out to be 16 by 5. X3 is coming out to be how much? 32 by 5. So automatically X1 will be equal to what? 0. So one resource is unutilized. Okay. S1, S2 is also equal to 0. Okay. There is no slack in this equation. And Z max, this is not minimum now. This is Z max. I hope you are understanding because we convert every question of minimization into maximization. So since we were asked to find minimization and Z max is coming out to be how much? Z max is coming out to be minus, so therefore minus 768 by 5. Therefore Z mean will be equal to minus of Z max, which will be 768 by 5. Okay. So when we convert anything from minimization to maximization, our answer will be negative for the Z. We need not worry. This is coming out to be negative only because we have converted it into maximization problem. So when we change the signature, on when we change maximization to minimization, we will always get z to be negative. Even for minimization, z can never be negative. It will always be positive. Always remember, z will always be positive. Always remember. And you need not change the sign of x1, x2, x3 variable. Those variables will automatically take care. You don't have to worry. In the solution, automatic care is taken of those variables. Automatic care is taken. Okay, you just need to change z from maximization to minimization. For that, you need to change the sign of z value. Okay, thank you.